comprehensive case, Watson. It starts in the cellar and ends on a rooftop. So says Sherlock Holmes near the climax of the case of the gunpowder plot. Welcome, my name is Harry Bartell, and I'm here to present two more new adventures of Sherlock Holmes. Guy Fawkes Day falls on November 5th and is one of the most celebrated holidays in England. In America, its only equivalent would be our Halloween night, but Guy Fawkes Day has nothing to do with goblins and ghosts and things that go bump in the night. It celebrates the prevention of a terrible plot to blow up England's House of Commons. I won't go into the story behind Guy Fawkes Day because Dr. Watson will explain it all as this Sherlock Holmes adventure unfolds. Denis Green and Anthony Boucher did a clever thing when they devised this story. They first reveal the original story through Dr. Watson, then repeat the story as an adventure of Sherlock Holmes. But it isn't as simple as that. Being the clever writers they are, Green and Boucher added new twists and turns that send the listener down a path of circumstances and clues that seem obvious at first, but are really devious in nature. The final solution to the case is a total twist on the original story. Here's an interesting note. Most radio mysteries were solved at the end of the broadcast when the evidence was revealed and the criminal brought to justice. Interestingly, the solution to this story is presented almost 5 minutes before the end of the show. From that point, the listener is taken forward to a second climax that brings the adventure to a close. This was unusual in the Sherlock Holmes series, which tended to follow a linear pattern in its weekly broadcasts. I say I piqued your curiosity. Well, you'll hear how Sherlock Holmes solves this crime in a moment. Anyone familiar with the original Conan Doyle stories is aware of the Baker Street Irregulars, a band of ragamuffins that Sherlock Holmes employed to help him in times of a crisis. Not only are the Irregulars mentioned in this story, but you'll have a chance to meet two of them. A nice touch, it moves the action forward. Here again, Green and Boucher gave Basil Rathbone a chance to play another character as well as the great detective. Today, children roam the streets of London celebrating Guy Fawkes Day, singing that famous song that's come down 4 centuries through history, "Please to Remember the 5th of November." Now, without further ado, here are Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson in the case of the gunpowder plot.
This episode from the life of Sherlock Holmes will be transmitted to our men and women overseas by shortwave and through the worldwide facilities of the Armed Forces Radio Service. Petri Wine brings you Basil Rathbone and Nigel Bruce in the new adventures of Sherlock Holmes. The Petri family, the family that took time to bring you good wine, invites you to listen to Dr. Watson tell us another exciting adventure he shared with his good friend, that master detective, Sherlock Holmes. And if you ask me, the best way to listen to that story is to do it with a glass of port wine right handy. Petri California Port. No kidding, that Petri Port is just swell for any time good friends get together to talk things over. You couldn't ask for a more delicious wine. Why, just looking at the deep, rich red color of that Petri Port tells you that here's a wine with a flavor that comes right from the heart of sun-ripened grapes. If you haven't ever tried Petri Port, why not get a bottle and have a glass after dinner tomorrow night? It's a perfect after-dinner wine, you know. And share that port with your family and your friends. Don't forget, when you serve Petri Port, you can serve it proudly. Because after all, the name Petri is the proudest name in the history of American wines. And now let's keep our weekly appointment. Good evening, Dr. Watson.
Good evening, Mr. Bartell. Draw up a chair.
Thank you.
That's it. By the way, do you know what date it is?
November 5th, isn't it?
That's right. In England, it's known as Guy Fawkes Day. Have you ever heard of it?
It's something to do with a gunpowder plot, isn't it?
Yes, Mr. Bartell, it is. And as Sherlock Holmes and I had a very unusual adventure on the 5th of November many years ago, it seems appropriate that I should tell you about it tonight. Before I begin, I think it might help you to appreciate the true flavor of the story if I tell you a little about the origin and the customs of Guy Fawkes Day.
Swell idea, Dr. Watson.
Well, my boy, On November the 5th, 1605, exactly 340 years ago today, King James I was about to attend the opening of Parliament when a plot was discovered to blow up the House of Lords during the ceremony.
And the chief conspirator was Guy Fawkes, I suppose?
Yes, he was. He was captured in a vault immediately below the House of Lords, a vault full of barrels of gunpowder. Of course, he and his fellow conspirators were executed. And ever since then, November the 5th has been known as Guy Fawkes Day.
Well, how's it celebrated, Doctor?
Well, it's a great time for the youngsters, Mr. Bartell. They black their faces, throng the streets, begging for pennies, and build bonfires in which to burn effigies of Guy Fawkes. These effigies are life-size dummies, stuffed with straw and dressed in old clothes. The children parade them in the streets chanting rhymes. Well, now, let me see. Please to remember the 5th of November. Guy Fawkes Guy, hit him in the eye.
The kids must have quite a time. Sort of like Halloween, huh, Doc?
Yes, not unlike it, my boy. Well, now that I've told you something about the customs of Guy Fawkes Day, I'll get on with my story. It began just before lunch, I remember, on November the 5th, 1899. The day was foggy and cold, and Holmes and I were seated each side of a blazing fire in our Baker Street rooms. From outside, we could hear the sound of voices laughing and singing. Suddenly, Holmes rose and crossed to the window, opened it, and looked out.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.